Good morning, students. So today we are going to start with the book exercise of chapter 3, Agrarian Structure under the British, chapter 3 of history. So first of all, very short answer type question. First question is, when was the decennial settlement started? So the settlement was introduced in the 1790 by the Lord Cornwallis. Question number 2, who suffered the most from the decennial settlement? Pigeons suffered the most from the settlement. When did the Indigo Rebellion take place? So this took place in the 1859 in Bengal. Question number 4, what was the indigo? Indigo is a plant which grows in a tropical regions. It produced a rich blue color, which was used by a cloth manufacturers to dye the cloth. What do you mean by a indigo commission? Indigo commission was set up to inquire into the entire system of indigo production and the plight of the riots in the year 1860. Indigo commission kya tha? Jo ki set up kara gaya tha to inquire about all the system of indigo production से related जो भी rebellion हुआ था, was it right or wrong, and what was this all indigo production? Then we have a short answer type question. Question 1, what did the British do to increase their financial resources? To increase the financial resources, the British focused on the different sources of revenue. The land revenue was framed out for more profit annually to the highest bidder. The tax collector used to collect more revenues and did not pay attention to the quality of land and peasants were exploited. They introduced the quinquennial settlement, decennial settlement, the Mahalwari settlement, the Rayotri settlement. So basically they have introduced many settlements through which they can earn more financial resources to have more revenue. Discuss the merits and demerits of the permanent settlement. So merits were, this ensured a fixed and a permanent income for the state irrespective of the produce. Agar kam bhi produce hua, they will get a fixed and a permanent income. Then it would increase production of the agriculture and make zamindars rich. Now since they have to pay a fixed amount, so they can increase their production. Or production badhegi to isse zamindars ka profit badhega. Demerits, it created feudalism at the top and serfdom at the bottom. It proved to be a financial disaster for the company as increase in production could not raise share of the revenue which was fixed. Ab agar wo log apni marzi se apna production bada de, to usse company ko koi fayda nahi tha since they are only paying a fixed amount. Then question number 4, what led to the revolts of the peasants? The harsh revenue policies, oppression of zamindars, confiscation of hereditary lands, and widespread calamity due to the famines aroused feelings of anger and rebellion among the peasants. So there were several revolts of the peasants in the 19th century. Why did the British encourage growth of commercial crops? Name some of these crops. The British company encouraged growth of commercial crop as such crops could be utilized by the British in their manufacturing industries. Such crops included cotton, jute, indigo, oil seeds, wheat, sugarcane, coffee, etc. Question number 6, why did the fakirs and sannyasi rise in revolt? Because the famine of Bengal deprived them of their means of income. They were joined by the angry peasants, thus feelings of the anger due to the calamity and harsh tax policies of the government forced them to rise in the revolt. Give a brief account of settlement introduced by the Thomas Munro in South India. Thomas Munro introduced the Rayotwari settlement in Madras Presidency, which was extended to the Bombay Presidency and Assam. In South India, land actually belonged to the cultivators or ryots since generation. So he felt that land settlement must be made directly with ryots. The revenue to be paid by the cultivators depended upon the quality of land and the crop produced. The land revenue was fixed at 50% of the rental for a maximum period of 30 years. The ryots would be owner of land as long as he paid the revenue. Then long answer type question. Question number one, how were the peasants affected by the agrarian policies of the British? So what were the policies? What were the impacts of these policies? First of all, there was a conflict of classes. New social classes like the landlord, moneylenders, traders and the peasants came in the society. They often came into the conflicts for their personal benefits. Then impoverishment of peasantry, that after the decline of cottage industry due to the import of British manufactured goods, more people turned to agriculture. Small pieces of land produced less and peasants were becoming poorer and poorer. Also, there was a disintegration of village communities. In case of a non-payment of revenues, peasants were forced to leave their land holdings and go other places for work. Rural indebtedness, money lenders exploited peasants. Their lands were taken by them in case of non-payments of debt and interest. Growth of commercial crops, farmers started crop production according to the market. Their crops were bought by middlemen at low price and he earned benefits himself. Question number two, what was the Mahalwari system? Discuss. The Mahalwari system was introduced in 1922 in Western UP, the central provinces and in some portion of Punjab. In this system, the village or the Mahal was made the unit of or revenue settlement. The village land was considered to be the land of village for which village community was responsible for payment of land revenue. The state demand was fixed at 95% of rental, so system failed due to the excessive demand of state. So this was a Mahalwari system. Then what was the Wahhabi movement? Discussed. This movement advocated the revival of Islam's. Syed Ahmed of Raebareli was the leader of this movement. Under this British rule, the Wahhabis were deprived of their power and authority. They condemned the British policies and spread anti-British sentiments. They were joined in the revolt by the peasants and the artisans who were already suffering under the British rule. Un sab logon ne bhi inke sath join kara, to already Britishers ke rule ki wajah se bahut suffer kar rahe the. So this was all about your book exercise. The question 1 and question 5, that means your MCQ and your match, the following you will do on your own, that you have to do in your book only, and these question answers you will do in your FAIR notebook. So that's all for today, and that's all about your chapter. We are going to start with the second chapter of geography in the next class. So that's it for today. Thank you and take care.